Bienvenidos a Nueva York, un programa dedicado a la cultura hispanoparlante en la Gran Manzana.
My name is Maria Ordonez and I'm running for City Council in District 7 in Manhattan, which is parts of Washington Heights, West Harlem, and parts of the Upper West Side. I'm 21 years old, and the moment I decided to run was actually like a couple years back. You know, I started doing work and organizing in my community, and I started to see where the issues were. I started knocking on doors in every single door in my building. I started knocking doors in the community. I started talking to people. I started talking to the small business owners. And what you hear are the same things. You know, people like us aren't being heard. I can't afford rent. I don't have access to healthcare. I don't have access to quality education. It's about giving everyone the same opportunity, the same chances, because going to school, having a roof over your head, that makes a difference for working people. It makes a difference in their livelihood. And seeing that and seeing my experiences and hearing from my parents, that inspired me. And I saw that as a 21-year-old, if I can stand up and do this and make a statement and run, I can raise money and raise more money than anyone who is running right now for this fundraising period. Then that is a statement, and that is making history in itself. And I'm showing everyone else that it does not matter your color of your skin, your gender, your ethnicity, your sexual orientation. You can run and no one can stop you, because that's the problem of the system. We want to make it so it's all about the status quo and power, and you have to listen to whoever's on top and you have to listen to the establishment. But that's not how this works. We have to put power back to the people. It's about people power. And that's how I'm running this campaign. For the people, by the people, para el pueblo. The most important thing when someone is running is to have the trust of your family and support of your family. And I'm honored and I am proud and humbled to have that support, because just like we build a family in our community, your most immediate family is also really important. And that's how we've been growing in this community as a family, and I hope to continue that. Growing up, I was always passionate about like reading the newspaper. I read about career events, and I engaged in so much discussion about politics. Like, I remember like when in 2008 when we had elections, and in 2016 when we had that, you know, very unfortunate case where we elected someone who hates immigrants, who hates the complete base of this country. We're all immigrants in this country, and we all came for a reason. Whether it was back in the 1800s or it was just in the 1980s, like my parents. And, you know, we spoke about that at home. We talk about, you know, politics. It's part of our family, because politics directly affects families like mine. It directly affects Latino families and these communities. I did see people treat me differently because of the color of my skin, or because I was a woman, or because I was Latina. In the beginning, you don't realize what people are doing to you. You just realize that there's something wrong. But then, you know, after, you know, reading, talking to people, you come to realize what this really is, and it's called racism. It's called discrimination. We tend to think that because of the color of your skin, you can't do something because of your gender. We continuously undermine the voices of women. So we have to fight for women to have the same opportunities to go to school, to have the same access to healthcare, for, you know, to be able to have abortions, because women are owners of their own body. I've seen that growing up, but if only, that just made me want to run even more, because we need to talk about these issues. We need to bring them to the table. If we don't run, then we're not going to be talking about women's rights, or, you know, Latinas having a place here. You know, like, look back a couple decades. Were we talking about Latinas? Maybe not, because Latinas weren't running, but it took one Latina to do it. It took Sonia Sotomayor on the Supreme Court. It took Ocasio. It took Jessica Ramos, Catalina Cruz. And now for District 7, it's taking me. I'm gonna stand up and I'm gonna talk about women. I'm gonna talk about Latinas, because it's a moment that we're heard. When someone runs, there's always that possibility, right? And if you're running, you're saying that you're gonna win all the way, then you're not looking at the reality. I wanna win. You know, I wanna represent this community, because I know that I'll represent them well, like they should be, and bring their voices to City Hall. But, you know, when I think about the possibility of not winning, what I do know is that we're building a movement, and that whatever happens, the one thing I did do, and that I will make sure to continue to happen and to happen is to amplify the voices of these women, to amplify the voices of Latinas, to talk about their experiences at their households, to talk about what it means to work in a small business or what it means to go to work at 5 a.m. and then come back home and pick up their children and go home and do the job of a housewife. And, you know, it's a 24-hour job. What I will do is build that movement and build a movement that will continue, because this is just not about me. It's about many other women who have gone what I've gone through, who have families like mine, who are facing the same issues. And I will do that work, and I will be there for other women, because we need a seat at the table. And that time is now, because we don't know what can happen, and we need to stand up and do that.
Cada uno de los pueblos de habla hispana en el mundo entero están representados en Nueva York. Contáctanos www.tv.cuny.edu.